All right, the Static Entertainment Update. Hey, I'm Dave Morris with a hard-hitting headline of the day. I have two words for you. Justin Bieber, joined by George Lang from the Oklahoma's Entertainment Desk. And those two words should strike fear in the heart of parents everywhere, I think. Absolutely. The question is, and we're going to get into the details, but for the second time in the week, Bieber is making headlines for not good reasons. Does he have time to entertain anymore?
It doesn't seem to be. I mean, the way I look at it, he might be kind of like laying the groundwork for the next phase of his career, which is just to be kind of a thug. I mean, it's like, okay, I'm going to spend a lot of time in the wilderness. I'm going to get arrested a few times. I'm going to turn myself in to Toronto police like he did yesterday.
And that's the first headline. That's the headline
exactly.
Yesterday. He's facing assault charges in Toronto for an incident in December.
That's right. He was actually smacking the back of the head of a chauffeur who was taking him around.
Which is bad form.
That's bad form. I mean, don't do that, okay? so he turns himself into Toronto police, and that very same day, he announces that he has a new music video. He goes on Instagram and announces, I've got this new music video, Confident. Yeah, that's great.
The heels of some action in Miami, which made all the big national networks. I mean, national news is covering this. Of course, the morning shows are having a field day with it, of him drag racing in Miami.
Yeah, exactly. These things are all kind of like lining up. And when you see these kind of trends like this, he's getting in just enough trouble. Nobody's being hurt much except for the chauffeur, and we don't know exactly what the nature of that was.
Unfortunately, no one was hurt at the drag racing incident.
That's exactly right. So he's getting in just enough trouble to achieve some serious headlines,
okay,
and a lot of web traffic. This morning on the Today Show, all the morning shows, they were interviewing everybody about Justin Bieber. On the Today Show, they talked to Barry Gibb, they talked to Dr. Phil, and they were all weighing in, and it's like, oh, he's such a troubled young man. I don't know.
You think maybe there's a little genius to this?
Very little genius.
Well, genius is...
Very little genius. Yeah.
Genius is a strong word in this case.
Okay, when you're a teen pop star, you have fairly limited options in how you're going to go forward and have an actual career as an adult. And you could be like, say, Justin Timberlake, who spends a lot of time as a teenager kind of building up a teen pop audience, and then he's so good, he's so talented, that he actually manages to hang on to those people and then build on them. I mean, he was able to convert people like me who had absolutely no time for NSYNC. He has a real career.
He actually has some talent, though.
That's right.
2020 was pretty good stuff, I thought.
Yeah.
He survived his scandal with the Super Bowl and Janet Jackson.
Totally. Yeah. Oh, I mean, he ran away from the blast radius on that one. It was amazing. But then you could also end up like Vanilla Ice, where you sell 10 million copies of To the Extreme, and the next year you can't sell out anything. You can't get people into your movie if you paid them. Or you end up like somebody like Chris Brown. Chris Brown, he has an audience and then he gets into trouble. Well, he decided to just double down on it. And so his whole business model is based on being a thug and cultivating that Team Breezy following that will, follow you no matter what you do. I think Bieber's trying to cultivate a Team Breezy light, And so it's like, maybe I'm going to get people to think about me differently, and I'm going to be tough now, and that's going to be the new phase of the Bieber
career. I think there's some similarities here between Bieber and Miley. Both had that that pop candy, the Nickelodeon Disney type image growing up, or that their career came from that.
Right.
Now they're both seeing headlines for twerking and smacking limo drivers and stuff. Except Miley hasn't been arrested.
That's right. Yeah, Miley doesn't get in trouble. She shocks a lot of people, but she hasn't done anything illegal as far as we know, or at least she hasn't been arrested for anything. Bieber is actually getting into pretty real trouble here. But I think that the whole idea is to change the image, because he's got an image problem. When you hit 19 and you're still thought of as a teen pop star, you got to do something else. Now, I think that there's a problem with it, because he hasn't been around that long, and he built his audience on 6 to 12 year old girls, okay? Well, most of those girls who discovered him and bought, you know, My World 2.0 a few years ago, well, now that, you know, they are still pretty much under the control of their parents, and their parents are looking at this guy and they're saying, I don't want you following this guy. I don't want you listening to him. Take him off your iPhone. I don't want you to listen to him anymore.
That hard-earned allowance is not going to
Justin Bieber. You know. So I think that's a real problem. Also, I think that the older audience, they look at him suspiciously, and they're not going to trust anything that this guy does. They're not going to say, "Oh, he's tough now. I'm going to follow him." It's not going to happen. I think that this is flawed all the way around.
Interesting stuff. Analysis from George Lang. More from him can be found. Let's see. Weekend Look is coming up in the Oklahoman, and also his blog, newsok.com/static blog, I believe.
Yes.
George Lang with the very latest on Justin Bieber.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir.